Wind 190 at 4. Visibility greater than 10 miles. Clear. Temperature 31, dew point 17. Altimeter 30.27. Nellis Air Force Base Information Romeo. Time 0300. Wind 190 at 4. Visibility greater than 10 miles.
And here's uniform.
And I've got you 5x5 on uniform.
Did you get it sorted?
Copy. The HUD came on as normal, then started flashing a few seconds later. I'm still looking into it a
ground
little
bit. Power is now on.
You good, dude?
Okay, I'm gonna have the sensors there. HUD turned off, followed by some smoke in the cockpit, so this is gonna be a ground abort. Continue with startup and go ahead and take off. I'll meet you over MOFA once I'm up.
Cool? Damn, man. Okay, yeah, I copy all. I'll just press and meet you at MOPA.
Pull up. Altitude.
Hey, what are you doing?
Ground of Liberty 11, ready taxi from Thunder 1810.
Liberty 1, Nellis ground taxi via Charlie Golf Alpha, hold short 03 right.
Contact tower, Liberty 1-2. Tower, Liberty 1-2, holding 03 right at Alpha, ready for departure.
Liberty 1-2, Nellis Tower, wind 190 at 4, clear for takeoff 03 right.
Clear for takeoff 03 right, Liberty 1-2.
Tower, contact Nellis departure. See you.
Departure Archer Liberty 1-2 with you at 5,000, heading towards Malapa.
Liberty 1-2, now with departure. Radar contact. Resume on navigation.
Resuming on navigation. Liberty 1-2.
Archer Liberty 1-1 with you at 5,000 feet near the truck stop. Liberty 1-1, climb and maintain Angel 7, resume on navigation.
Climb and maintain Angel 7, resuming on nav, Liberty 1-1.
Hey, good to see you. I've got you, Lima Charlie.
Right on. Okay, I'm heading your way. Just anchor up there at MOBA about 7,000 feet and I'll pick you up.
Copy.
We're still good on time, so we'll mess around Mead and then the dam before we push to Vegas if you're still happy to do so.
Hell yeah, might as well. Wow, that's really handy. I can see this will make rejoins so much easier, especially at night, and reduce visibility. I think our saddle's one of the best improvements coming from the Alpha.
Yeah, the saddle adds a ton to your SA and helps streamline a lot of processes. It'll really come into its stride once you get a little further in your training and start putting warheads on foreheads.
Looking forward to it.
I'm approaching the Mopa Overton area, so I'm going to make a right turn to follow the Mopa Valley to the southeast into Lake Mead. I want you to start pushing for the rejoin.
2.
The valley off to our right is known as the Mopa Valley. It is one of the rare green areas around here. It's really pretty down there, and the roads into it and out of it are pretty damn nice drive if you're in the corner.
You could say that. I have a Nissan GTR.
Ah, very nice. Well, if you decide to head down through there and have some fun, just be careful near the small towns, because the cops hammer all the coming up from Vegas on their weekend drive.
Noted. Thanks for the heads up.
right for Echo Bay.
Rog. So what's going to be the target for the flyby?
What do you mean?
Like, what's going to be the center point for our time over target?
Ah, it's going to be the casino with the Statue of Liberty out in front of it, of course.
I guess that should have gone without saying.
Perhaps. We're going to have our ground observer up on top of the Empire State Building there, calling out our timing for us.
Nice. Wow, you can really tell how much the lake level has dropped looking at the shoreline and the stuff that used to be lakefront.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy how much it's dropped. So there's a P-29 down there in Lake Mead that crashed way back. If the lake level has come down so much, I guess it's possible to dive on it now. I need to look into seeing if I can get in there and check it out.
Really? That's freaking cool. Isn't it kind of weird for a B-29 to be in Lake Mead, though?
Well, they were doing some secret squirrel work back then and would climb up real high, then dive down towards the lake, let them out, and do it all over again. I guess the pilots didn't pull out in time and they went in.
Wow. What were they working on? Did they get out okay?
Yeah, they all got out. They hit shallow, so it tore off some of the engines and skipped back up in the air, then came back down. They were working on a device called a sun tracker, which was an early IR tracking device. Led into AIM-9, so.
Damn, dude. Are you like a part-time historian or something?
No. They had a hour-long documentary on the whole B-29 thing on History Channel or something a while back. The only thing on during a school night, so I ended up watching it.
Okay. Copy. That makes sense. Cool story, though.
Alright, things are gonna pick up around here pretty quick. We need to transition back into McLaren's Class E airspace to fly over the Hoover Dam, which is usually pretty busy with choppers. I'll handle all communications with ATC, but I need you to keep up on what's going on and follow my lead. This is Bay Nellis Departure having us switch over to Las Vegas Approach here in just a minute. We can go ahead and tune into Vegas Approach though, since it will be on the Victor, and we can keep up with Nellis on the uniform.
Copy.
Cool, go ahead and tune into 125.25 for Vegas Approach and stand by.
Copy, 125.25. Set.
Oh yeah, I keep forgetting you have an airline job.
Tower,
That's some pretty rugged terrain down there.
Yeah, it looks pretty raw.
Ready on 257.
Patriot Liberty.
Over South Point, is that correct?
If able, we'd like to hold near Henderson Executive, please.
Copy, you guys are good to hold there at 4,500 feet if that works for you.
Yeah, 4,500 foot over Henderson Executive should be just fine, thanks.
Roger, just give us a heads up when you guys break into that orbit and start towards the strip. We'll have all helicopter traffic holding off the sea at least a mile from the strip under 2800. Anything west of that, from the ground up, is
I appreciate it. Approach and we'll give you a shot when we start pushing for the strip. Fly direct to Henderson, maintain 4500, Liberty 1. Coming up on a left turn. Another left.
turn coming up.
Yep.
So, Patriot is Lotus, Major Roberts. Have you met her already?
Negative. We've never been formally introduced.
Man, she knows the jet inside out. And on top of that, she's pretty alright. Expect to fly with her on authority or two through your training.
Awesome. That'll be a very welcome change of pace.
Wow, really? They usually get 4 or 5 sorties in before you guys want to jump ship.
Just busting your balls. You're doing fine.
Stand by for 2-minute hack.
Roger.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, hack. 2 minutes.
Copy. 2-minute hack. Okay, left hand turn and let's roll.
Right behind you.
Alright, bruh, let's make the 190th look good.
Always.
Stand by for the SIFN.
2's ready.
Approach, Liberty 1 is out of the hold, pressing toward a strip and descending to 3,000. Liberty, the airspace is yours, and thank you guys for doing this. Our distinct pleasure. Alright, here we go. I'm gonna need to slow down a little bit, so start getting into formation.
Roger.
Liberty is in from the south and looking good.
Copy, Liberty.
Be ready if we need to slow it down or push it up if they're playing fast or slow.
Timing looks good for now. Looks like we may be slowing down a bit. Stand by. Plus 10 seconds.
Copy.
Keep it coming. You're looking good.
Tight.
Working at it.
Alright, here comes the statue.
Shit, hot guys. That looked great.
Coming to the right, following the boulevard.
2.
Alright guys, have fun. That looked great. Well done.
Okay, that's the end of the pass. Let's pick it up a bit of altitude and contact approach.
Roger.
pattern up at the truck stop.
Liberty, Nellis approach. Continue inbound for the truck stop. Expect single ship landing clearance for 2-1 left.
Continue for the truck stop, Liberty 1. Did you have fun?
Yeah, man, that was freaking cool.
I thought so. I've never seen them let us do that before. Glad we got the chance to do it.
No shit. This is definitely going to be a highlight in the logbook. Thanks for the invite.
No problem. Thanks for tagging along. Oh, by the way, you're probably going to be meeting Lotus here pretty soon. She's going to help me plug some holes in the schedule that I can't make.
Finally, a break.
I see how it is. I'll let her know about all the problems I'm having with you and how you said her eyebrows were all jacked up.
Damn, straight in for the kill. Oh, I was just kidding. Please don't.
That's what I thought. Alright, we're coming up to the truck stop to get ready to anchor here until they clear you in for that approach.
Raj. So you're not gonna tell it, right?
Yeah, we'll see. Lotus can be, let's say intense. It behooves you not to get on her bad side. Ever.
Liberty 1-2, pick a right-hand orbit at the truck stop for me.
Right-hand orbit for Liberty 1-2.
Liberty 1-1, turn inbound for Nellis runway 21 left, contact tower.
Turning inbound and switching to tower, Liberty 1-1.
Liberty 1-2 is inbound for 21 left in. Switching your tower. See ya. Dallas Tower, Liberty 1-2, 10 miles north of the field for the straight in.
Liberty 1-2, Dallas Tower, copy. Report 5 mile final, 2-1 left.
Report 5 mile final for Liberty 1-2.
Liberty 1-1, Dallas Tower, contact ground when able.
Liberty 1-1, switching to ground.
Liberty 1-2 is 5 mile final, gear down, full stop for 21 left.
Liberty 1-2, Dallas Tower, wind 190 at 4, clear to land, 2-1 left.
Clear to land, 21 left, Liberty 1-2.
Altitude.
tower, contact ground on 257.8 when able.
Copy, 1-2, switching to ground. Nellis ground, Liberty 1-2, looking for taxi back to Thunder.
Liberty 1-2, Nellis ground, taxi to Thunder via Golf Charlie.
Taxi, Golf Charlie to Thunder, Liberty 1-2.
I need some cold beer.
I need 12.
Got any plans tonight?
Other than a cold beer?
Nope. A few of us are popping over to the Yale Club here in a bit. Should be a bit rowdy.
Sounds like my kind of party. I'm in.